Fabini started as an idea in my dad's head in the late 50s, which was a very idealistic time in India. He came here as a consultant to the Central Cottage Industries Corporation, and he loved the craft. So he went back to the U.S. when his contract ended in 1960, and he raised the initial capital for Fab India. It has a retail company that has Fab India, which has 120 stores, and a significant holding in a UK retailer with 78 stores, so the total of 200 stores. Fab India has incubated 17 community-owned companies through an investment vehicle, which functions like an in-house private equity fund. It only makes investments using Fab India's money into community-owned companies. It will not invest in anything else. And that fund has over the years seeded these 17 companies. And what's interesting now is as these companies become more successful and the artisan base increases, we've gradually been, you know, withdrawing and becoming a smaller player and giving that room to the artisans.
So we work with 35 to 40,000 artisans across the country. They have been aggregated into these 17 community-owned companies, which have been incorporated under the Companies Act. The goal always being that how do we extend the benefit down to the artisan on the ground, and how do we make him a partner in the profits of the company. When we started 3 years ago, we spent a lot of time on the road, actually traveling to villages, getting together groups of artisans, talking to them, explaining what a share means.
We were very lucky because we did the initial period with our own artisans who had tremendous faith in Fab India. They didn't understand shareholdings, but they trusted us. So they jumped into it because of trust, not because they had any understanding.
And today they're seeing the results of that. I mean, we're sitting in Jaipur, and the Jaipur company, 100 rupee share, is trading at 535 rupees.
Here they buy a share in this company because this company provides them employment, it provides them with finance, it provides them with design assistance, it provides them with raw materials. It's really a different concept from shareholding the way most people do it. In a community-owned company, the shareholders all know each other. It's a big difference. The management knows the shareholders, so there's a whole emotional dimension to a community-owned company which doesn't exist in a company where, say, you buy the shares in some Chennai company and you don't know the management. You know, it's a very intimate relationship here. Then these companies are working in the area in which the shareholders live. So if they see something going wrong, you know, like one of them told me at a meeting, he said, where you're putting the warehouse is in absolutely the wrong place because the trucks are not allowed to go there. They're intimately involved.
We look at the community-owned companies as becoming integral players in the communities where they're based. And going forward, we're looking at integrated community development projects, which would include healthcare, which would include education, which would include clean drinking water, rural tourism, appropriate energy, like solar energy or wind power.
As these community-owned companies expand their reach, they will be actually benefiting the community from where their shareholders live. These companies have a huge reference and a huge impact on your daily life. I feel we are onto a revolution. What has been interesting for me in this journey is seeing that how shareholder wealth has been created by actually not focusing only on profits. It's actually made us, in a strange way, more profitable. That, to me, is a very fulfilling journey because we've done something which nobody has done before and we've shown that it can work.
ये कंपनी अपने आप पर निर्भर है इतना बड़ा काम देने वाली कोई कंपनी नहीं है हिंदुस्तान में हजारों मीटर का जो ऑर्डर देती है कंपनी कोई कंपनी नहीं दे सकती
कारीगर को तो डबल प्रॉफिट है इसमें शेयर के ऊपर बहुत पैसा मिल रहा है उनको उसके बाद दूसरी कमाई जो काम करके देगा ये तो डबल कमाई है
डीएच आने से बाद हमारे पास फाइनेंशियल साउंड है मेरे पास दो गाड़ियां हैं बाइक्स है बच्चों के लिए मेरी बच्ची टेक्सटाइल डिजाइनर है जो दुबई में रहती है मेरा जो बच्चा है वो एमबीए किया उसने अभी एक जमाने में हम मजदूर कहलाते थे और आज हम आर्टिजन्स भी हैं और पूरी इंडिया में आज हमारा नाम है और इसी कंपनी की वजह से